said it. You just have to believe it and accept it.
Dr. Anthony L. Trice, dedicated to sound teaching, strong training, leadership, and development. Prayers are being answered and testimonies all around the world, helping change one life at a time. Find out how to be a partner with Anthony Trice Ministerial Network. And thank you for tuning in for today's message.
If you can be God-given, even if you try, that's not my subject. Okay. My subject on today is what's in God's hand is greater than what's in your hand.
Amen.
What's in God's hand is greater than what's in your hand. Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
What's in your hand?
What's in your hand?
Luke chapter 6 verse 38 read. Give. Jesus said give, comma,
and it shall be given unto you.
And it shall be given unto you.
Uh-huh.
Good measure. Good measure.
Pressed down.
He said, I'm going to press it down.
And shake it together.
In other words, I'm going to press it down, shake it together so I can pack it in.
Uh-huh.
Read.
And running over.
And he said, I'm going to cause it to run over. It's going to be so much.
Shall men give into your bosom.
Shall men give into your stomach or your belly. Notice Jesus said give. This word give means release it. Somebody say let it go.
Let it go.
Give. When you release what's in your hand, then God will release what's in his hand. Look what's in God's hand. Pressed down, shaking together, and running over. Just in case you didn't know, God's hand is bigger than your hand. So that's what we're going to deal with on this morning. What's in God's hand is greater than what's in your hand. We read on last week, Genesis chapter 26 verse 12, where it said that Isaac sold in the land. The Bible says he sold in that land. He didn't sow in any land. How many know when it comes to sowing, you got to sow in the right land? I don't sow into people that's out of order. You ever went to a vending machine, try to get a candy bar, and you put in the money, and you push the button, and it come out, then you look up the sign and say, I don't want it. When you sow into something or somebody that's out of order, there's no return. So the Bible says Isaac sowed in that land, and in the same year, God bypassed some time for Isaac. In the same year, the Bible says he received 100-fold blessing in the same year. Then the Bible says that he waxed great. Then the Bible said he went forward. Then the Bible says he was blessed by God. So all that was in that one seed that Isaac sowed. That one seed. This is the thing about seed sowing. You don't know what's in the seeds that you sow.
Amen.
I want to bring this out. We get ready to get into this lesson on this morning. Giving is God's system. Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
God has a system. Just like McDonald's.
Just like White Castle.
Just like Macy's. A business is a system. A system is a way of doing something, a careful or organized plan that controls the way something is done. How many know that everything has a system?
Amen.
Everything that God set up is a system. Well, God's system is seed, time, and harvest. God's system is what?
Seed,
time, and harvest. Now watch this. There are three things that God expects us to give to him. Say time,
time.
My talent,
and my money.
Time means God wants you to spend time with him. Time witnessing, time for praying, time of helping other people. Somebody say time.
Time.
And we can go on a little more time. God wants you to worship him. God wants you to come to church. God wants you to spend time in the word. God wants you to spend time praying. God wants you to spend time praying for people, witnessing people. Somebody say time.
Time.
Second, God wants your gift. How many folks can sing, but they won't get up here? How many people got beautiful smiles, but they won't become a preacher? They're not sincere. You got a gift of health. You can be an usher. There's a whole bunch of stuff you can do with your gifts and talents. But you bury your talents. Number three, God wants your money. God expects for you to support his work. And one of the things that happens with the body of Christ, the church world, the world criticizes us for giving our money to God. But they don't criticize you by giving your money to Masons and White Castles and Red Lobster. But they criticize us. And if you listen to that nonsense, you won't support God's work. You won't make an investment in God's kingdom. So don't listen to the world. I'm not finna, if the Bible says let every man be a lie, let the word, but it's amazing how we believe the doctor and the lawyer and the government before we believe God. You got to get this word for yourself. You can't tell me anything and I accept it. It's amazing how people can tell y'all anything and you swallow it. Hook, line, and sinker. That's because you don't know the word. So God expects for us to give. Jesus said, it's in red, give, comma. Everything that's on this side of the comma is what God gonna do. On this side of the comma is God what God wants you to do. All right, 1 Kings chapter 3. What's in God's hand is greater than what's in your hand. 1 Kings. Start at verse 3 and read all the way down to verse 15. Read.
And Solomon loved the Lord.
Let's stop right there. And Solomon loved the Lord. Do you love the Lord?
Amen.
And we quick to say I love God, but love is the action word. And our love for God has to be demonstrated. I can't just say I love my wife, but I never do nothing for her. I love my wife, but I don't take care of her. I love my wife, but I ain't trying to meet her needs. I don't love her. I'm just lip service. But it's the same thing with God. People honor God with their mouth, but their heart is far from him. And it's easier to say something opposed to you doing it. It's not easy loving God. How many think it's easy loving God? It ain't easy. Watch this. Your child get killed. And God, God expects you to keep serving him. Most people, when it happens, they backslide. Your house burned down. You just shouted a few minutes ago. Can you keep loving God if your house burned down? Can you keep loving God if he let you catch cancer? Can you keep loving God if you lose all your money in the bank? The fact of the matter, you don't know. If your spouse leave you, y'all talk back to me. Love is an action word. Love is something you have to demonstrate. Anybody can fix their mouth and say they love God, but can you love God when your heart is broke? Can you keep loving God if you don't get married? Can you keep loving God if he don't do nothing else for you? The Bible says Solomon loved God. Read.
Walking in the statutes of David his father.
The Bible says he walked in the precepts and the laws of his father David. Read.
Only he sacrificed and burned incense in high places.
The Bible says only he made sacrifices and burned incense in high places. How many know that worshiping God would take you higher?
Amen.
How many will go higher?
Amen.
How many will go higher in their finances?
Amen.
How many know you just ain't finna go just because you want to.
Amen.
I want to do a whole bunch of stuff. But am I want a mansion. But it costs. You want, some stuff has a price tag. You go to the Rolls Royce dealer, you, they ain't finna negotiate with you. Well, what about this? They're gonna get out of here. How many know stuff that's valuable ain't no negotiation? Either you pay for it or you don't. See, we want something for nothing. We want to be anointed. I want to be used where you want to be crushed. You want to be stepped on. You want to be spit on. You want to be lied on. Because that's how you get anointed. You don't get anointed being cute. The anointing comes from being stepped on and crushed.
Gideon to sacrifice there.
The Bible said, and King Solomon went to Gibeon, which was a high mountain in Jerusalem. What did he go there for? To sacrifice there. In other words, to give something that he felt or cost him. Sacrifice means is when you're willing to do something for somebody else. It ain't too many poor people like that.
Amen.
Read.
For that was the great high place.
That was the great high place. Watch this. Read.
1,000 burnt offerings did Solomon offer on that altar.
He went up above Gibeon and gave God $1,000 seed. It's something about $1,000. If you've never given $1,000 into the kingdom, you never sold that.
All right.
It's amazing how things open up when you sow a certain amount of money.
Yeah.
Watch. This type of seed, if you feel this. See, a lot of us really ain't giving. We think we give it. Do you feel what you give? It's only two reasons why you feel when you give. I like that. The two reasons is, if you feel every time you give, it's because your heart's something wrong with your heart. Because if you feel a $5 bill and you got $5,000, that's a sign something wrong with your heart. If you don't give to God freely and you always feel it, that's a sign that your God is your money. $5 is nothing for me to give. $5,000 ain't nothing for me to give. But $10,000? I don't feel it. You know why? I ain't never gave it. But watch this. In order to get something you never had, you gotta do something you never get. So you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna give God $10,000. You know why? Because I want what's in his hand.
Amen.
And what's in God's hand is greater than what's in your hand. Amen.
Push
it. What's in your hand? That's the trigger. The trigger is what's in your hand. So the Bible said that Solomon gave $1,000 offering to God. Look what happened after he did this. Verse 5.
The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream.
God stepped in his dream. He had an encounter with God as soon as he released what was in his head. Watch this, read.
And God said, ask what I shall give thee.
He said, Solomon, what do you need me to do for you? Most of us asking God, what can he do for us? Most of us have never had God ask us, what can he do for you? dimension. See, anybody can talk, but can you put your money where your mouth is? That's your whole bunch of folks that. They can give a tip. You know why? Somebody say why? Where your treasure is, your heart gonna follow your treasure. Wherever you put your money, that's where your heart's gonna be. If you don't put your money in the kingdom, then your heart ain't in God. Your heart is wherever you put your money. I'm gonna work this. Read.
And Solomon said.
And Solomon said, now he dialoguing with God in the dream. Read.
Thou hast shown unto thy servant David, my father, great mercy.
Read.
According as he hath walked before thee in truth and in righteousness and in uprightness of heart with thee. And thou hast kept for him this great kindness, that thou hast given him a son to sit on his throne.
Read.
And it is this day.
Uh-huh.
And now, O Lord my God, thou have made thy servant king instead of David my father.
He was a little boy. He was a kid, and God made him king. Read.
And I am but a little child.
Read.
I know not how to go out or come in.
Know what he's saying? I don't even know what I'm doing. Have God ever did something for you and you didn't know what you was doing? This is the time God has blessed me. I didn't know what to do. I said, Lord, what do I do with this? Mind-blowing stuff. Read.
And thy servant is in the midst of thy people.
I'm in the midst of your people.
Which you have chosen.
Uh-huh.
A great people.
Read.
That cannot be numbered nor counted for multitude.
Verse 9.
Give, therefore, thy servant an understanding heart.
Notice, he didn't ask for no car. He didn't ask for no spouse. He didn't ask for no money. He didn't ask for that. The first thing he asked God for was an understanding heart. You know what? Now watch this. Think about this. God said, what can I do for you? So he could have said anything. He could have asked him. Right. But you know what he asked for? Understand. You know why he asked for this? Because his heart was right. Some of us asking for some stuff, and the reason why we asking for this particular thing is because our heart's not right. When your heart is right, then your prayers are right. Watch this. I'm going to go and give it to you. Then I'm going to get back to this. Why would God give you money and things and put you over people and you don't have no wisdom?
Amen.
You don't have no understanding.
Amen.
You don't have no deserving. But you want God to give you all this stuff. If he did, you're not going to keep it. So what God does when you ask him for something or when you pray for it, God has order. So if you're asking God for a lot of money and stuff, and God, if you give me this, I'm going to bless the church. He going to see. But the first thing that he's going to give you is wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and discernment. And Lord knows when you get stuff, you're going to need some discernment because you got a lot of crooks out here. You got a lot of con artists out here. You got a lot of schemers out here. And some of them even in the church. I've literally had people try to con me. And when they first came to me, they came to me like a sheep. But they was, when I just sat back and watched them, and then the wolf came out of them. I'm finna help some of y'all. Some of y'all got some wolves in your life, but they appear to be sheep. And when they get what they want from you, it's gonna come out. And that's why so many young ladies are messed up. These guys ain't got nothing, and you giving them sex.
You're right about that.
He ain't got nothing.
Nothing.
And he in your life. did it. You ain't the thief on the cross.
Amen.
Wow. That's too big of a risk for you to take. Yes, yes, yes. Read.
Give therefore unto that servant an understanding heart to
so
judge.
Solomon said, give me an understanding heart so I can make good decisions when it comes to your people. It's amazing to me, people always want to be over folk. How you want to be over people and you can't even control yourself? You can't even stop talking yourself. You don't even do what you say do. It's amazing why we so quick to run our mouths. Read.
To judge thy people.
Read.
That I may discern between good and bad.
Uh-huh.
For who is able to judge this so great a people?
Read.
And the speech pleased the Lord.
Displeased God. What he asked God for was the will of God to be done. God, I don't want a whole bunch of stuff. I don't want this, that, the other. What I want to do this job right, I want wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And it takes time to get God's wisdom, to get God's knowledge, to get God's understanding. They don't come overnight. They come over time through your experiences. Too many of us are wet behind the ear. We don't have no experiences on our belt. In other words, adversity is God's university. You want to go to college? God's college is suffering. That's why it takes time. You know, God don't do stuff overnight. God called Moses at 40. He didn't sin until he was 80. The Bible said that Jesus Christ did not come to the fullness of time. Jesus was here for 33 years before he started public ministry. And you've been in church 2 weeks, and you done got some cards. You call yourself an apostle. You call yourself a prophet. Your motive wrong. You want to be seen. You're going to be judged greater than everybody. When you take a title, God judges you greater than everybody else. And I just believe it's a special place in hell for preachers. I believe it, that you're going to be whipped with many stripes. When you say you're a preacher, a prophet, an apostle, an evangelist, a bishop, whatever you call yourself, if you don't live it, you're going to go to hell.
Amen.
And so many people grab the title. I want to be important. Call me title. Call me so-and-so.
Right.
You know what God called us for? To live right. Who preaching that? Read.
And God said unto Solomon, because thou have asked this thing, and have not asked for thyself long life, neither have asked riches for thyself, nor have asked the life of thine enemies, but have asked for thyself an understanding to discern judgment, behold, I have done according to thy words. I have given thee a wise and an understanding heart, so that there was none like thee before thee, neither after thee shall any arise like unto thee.
So what was in Solomon's hand, what was in God's hand, was greater than what Solomon. So what did Solomon give God? $1,000. What did God give Solomon? Wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and discernment. It's not one-sided. And we trying to get stuff from God for nothing. That ain't how this works. Well, I ain't got $1,000. Well, give God what you supposed to give. But I'm just telling you, this is what the scripture says that he gave. And this moved God. You know why it moved God? Because it moved him. If it ain't moving you, guess what? It sure ain't moving God. Wisdom costs. Wisdom does not come cheap. And you can't buy wisdom. But the wisdom that comes from God, it's going to cost you something. In other words, God has to be able to trust you with it. Watch this, read.
And I have also given thee that which thou have not asked.
And Solomon, I'm going to also give you some things that you have not asked for. Mm-hmm. Read.
Both riches and honor.
I'm going to give you riches, and I'm going to give you honor, respect, and a good name. God, only God can give you that. Read.
Dr. Anthony L. Trice is determined to take the gospel around the world to a people that are hurting mentally, physically, and financially. Your prosperity is in your seed. God has shown him how to be prosperous, successful, and with integrity. Ecclesiastes 10 and 19, money answered all things. We would like you to partner with us. Help us spread the word of God. Sign up as a monthly partner today and take advantage of this special offer. For a love token of $30 plus shipping and handling, you will receive this prosperity package, which includes Your Prosperity is in Your Seed, a powerful teaching CD, and prosperity oil. All partners will receive a monthly CD, newsletter, and much, much more. For more information, call 314-659-8522 or visit us online at www.anthonytrice.org. You can write to us at 7200 West Forest, St. Louis, Missouri, 63136, and we thank you for your support.
Hey, that was a powerful, awesome word from the Lord. I would like to thank you for tuning into our television broadcast on today. Amen, God is doing some awesome things here in this ministry. Our members are being delivered. They're being healed. They're experiencing financial breakthrough. And I want you to experience that same anointing that's on this ministry in your life by partnering with me here at Anthony Trice Ministry. You can go to my website at anthonytrice.org and become a monthly partner. God bless you.
Thank you for watching today's broadcast. If ever in St. Louis area, please come visit Covenant for Life Christian Center at 7200 West Forest, St. Louis, Missouri, 63136. Or give us a call at 314-659-8522. For more information on how to get connected, write to us or visit us online at anthonytrice.org. And we thank you for your continued support.